Hello everybody and welcome back to Thornton Farm. So we're going to do something different today. It's about time we did something different because everything I've done so far has been sort of a repeated job. I've done it all before. So we'll shut the door on that. And we need to jump into the John Deere tractor. We're not going to use the fence today, unfortunately. In fact, we're not really going to use any tractors today except for this one because we need to do a bit of mowing. And to do the mowing, we obviously need a mower. But I'm not going to go for one which goes onto the three-point linkage. I'm going to go for like a ride-on mower, that kind of thing. I think it would be quite interesting to see in Farming Simulator. Now, obviously, in FS13, you did actually start off with, I think it was a Krone ride-on mower kind of thing, like a council one. I didn't really use it too often. But yeah, I am aware of the one you started off with, so if my voice doesn't go, we'll continue with the video, and we're going to go and buy this mower, and we need to buy a trailer as well. Now, I did consider actually putting the trailer on the quad bike, but it might be a bit too big, because apparently it's 30 foot. So I think that is probably going to be a little bit too big for the quad bike, but we'll see. Lots of visitors at Stonehenge today. Yep, really hot here today in the UK. Well, at least it is where I am. First time this year, I think. It's been long overdue. But the shop is obviously just here. Let's go into here. And the prices are actually quite reasonable. They're not cheap, but they're also not expensive, I wouldn't say. Except for the trailer, that's a little bit expensive, but it is a big trailer. So let's go into the shop. And first of all, let's buy the trailer, because we're going to need this either way. It's £25,000, which sounds expensive, but it is 30 foot, so it's huge. And yeah, I think that is just way too big for the quad bike. We should probably move the tire rack, to be honest. Oh, you use a forklift. I didn't know that before. We'll have to get the telehandler up here if we have time then, just to get that moved. And actually, having that trailer on the tractor makes it way too low at the front. It's tipping up and the rear wheels are even off the ground. So really, the pickup would have been perfect. But I think just for today, we'll have to do it this way. So yes, let's unfold the back of it. And to do that, you press K and M. If you press M, it lowers them down. And if you press K, it will actually lift it up. So let's jump out the tractor. We now need to buy the mower. It isn't the one from Farming Simulator 13, sorry, but it is, it's still a very decent one. Now, you might be wondering, how have we suddenly been able to afford all of this stuff? Well, let me just show you. If we go into our storage, you'll see that I have sold absolutely everything at quite a good price as well. So, yeah, that is the reason why we can suddenly afford it all. Otherwise, there'd be no chance of it. We do still have to repay the loan, actually. But I'm not too desperate anymore because we have repaid everything we took out. Everything else is what we started off with. Alright, so put the quad bike on here. There should be enough space. I bet you're dying to see the mowers. You might have even used them, actually. Because they've been out a while. Right, so if we go into the mod section, go into mowers, you'll see there are three here. X-Mark. We've got the X-Mark Laser Z. This is, I'm surprised actually this isn't the cheapest ride-on because it doesn't have the bagging unit on the back like this one here does. The price is exactly the same. So I think it really just depends how you want to do it. And I think I'm going to go with the bagger. There is also the stander, which is basically you ride on the back. So it's kind of still a ride-on, but you don't sit down. So it's kind of the cheaper but still lazy style, if you want to put it that way. Although no, they're not really that lazy. The sit-down one's obviously the most luxurious. So these are the ones we're going to go for today. The laser bagger is my one, 25 horsepower. So this should be amazing. Can't wait to get on the trailer and give it a go. Well, not on the trailer, but when we get back to the orchard. It's pretty big. And you can see, well, obviously it's much bigger because it's got the side discharge chute. And I believe that would be powered and it would actually force it up the chute into the bagger on the back. You can disable this by pressing O. I don't think you see anything change in the animation, but I'm guessing it just doesn't collect it anymore. So that is how that works. Now this might also be a bit of a guide for anyone who has used this before and had a bit of trouble with it. Basically, if you just drive, if you put your foot to the floor, it doesn't really go anywhere. It steers and the wheels are turning very, very slowly. My foot is to the floor. Basically, to get these things to work, you actually have to put the four-wheel drive on and the diff lock on the drive control. Otherwise, they don't go anywhere. I don't know the reason for it, but that is what you have to do to get it to work. So if you've downloaded this before and you're having problems, or if you're going to download it now, that is something to definitely be aware of. I might reverse it on, actually, because we've got the like the jockey wheels on the front, and they might grab the ramp. Never put it on here before. That's actually pretty good. And yes, there is tons of space. It does overhang slightly, but nothing to be dangerous, I don't think. Right, so, well, don't want to crash into the quad bike. We'll leave it there. Turn the engine off, put the handbrake on, and I think you can actually lock these on. It actually says bales, I think, but I think you can still lock them. So if we've gone to here, it's a, yeah, lock bale. Press O, and I think it has actually locked them onto there. I can't say for sure, but we'll see if they move. But we are now ready to go over to the orchard and do a bit of mowing. This has been long overdue. It's quite a blind turning there. I always worry that there's going to be a car coming, because you can't really see. They're still in place. I think the locking function does work, and it says for bales, so actually using the trailer for bales would be a fantastic idea. Oh, that's a good test to see if they shift. Nope, they're definitely locked in place. That's brilliant. So it's definitely worth downloading this. As usual, the download link is below if you want to try them out. In this video, I'll just be using the laser bagger, but yeah, there are two more. So this is one of two orchards. We have two of them. We might do them both, it just depends how we're doing for time. If we don't do it today, we'll do it tomorrow, but hopefully I'll be able to do it all today, blitz through it. I don't think we will bag straight away, but the reason why I've gone for this model is because we will do, because it'd be very handy for the sheep. The reason why we're not going to do it today is because we don't actually own the sheep yet, so it'll be kind of pointless, but we'll have to see. Let me just put the ramp down. So let's jump on. You do have to disable the bale lock function, or just the locking mechanism, whatever you want to call it. Otherwise, when you start it, it still won't move. And it's a good idea to make sure your wheels are straight before you start to move off the trailer. Right, so this is really long, because it hasn't been cut at all. This should work. Hopefully it's disabled. I think it is. I can't say for sure. But let's start it up. Nope, it's not. Now it is. So we're dropping all back on the ground. I think it actually looks better that way anyway. But we can do it at some speed. 25 horsepower here. And this is like a commercial mower. Not your everyday out of your local hardware store. Put ride-on mower. You know, you can get these really cheap ones. No, this one is very expensive. I can't really tell by the sound of it, but it sounds like it's petrol, but you'd have thought it'd be diesel. Obviously, I am fanatical about mowers, so I should know really. They tend to be diesel, ones like this, but there are some petrol ones out there. Yes, if the price of the bagging one was more expensive, I wouldn't have gone for it. It's only because we get more for our money. I tend to think of it that way. It seems to be quite a good way to think. And at least now we've sold everything, we are not too low on money anymore. So we can afford machinery maintenance and stuff like that. Although, we have nothing else to sell, so we do need to do some more harvesting. I think we'll do some more very soon. Actually, thinking about that, do we have any fields to harvest? I should have really considered that, but very soon we'll have fur number 11 again. But it'd be a bit boring if we do that one straight away. Notice I'm only doing this area because it's the only area with trees in. I suppose you could actually create your own silage pit using a ride-on mower. So every time it's full, take it to the silage pit and then you can ferment it at the end. That'd actually be pretty fun, but very slow. I should do that. I think that'd be quite interesting to see. This is when you really do need like a zero turn mower, like this one, because you can go right around the trees. With a tractor, it's much harder. To be honest, if you haven't got the drive control installed, I don't know if it will still work or not. I don't know if it will drive, but that is the solution for drive control users. These trees are also fully laden with fruit, so very soon we'll be able to harvest them. We don't really make that much money from them, but it's extra once you've bought the kiosk. That is the only issue. Anyway, yes, I love this mower. It makes such a change from just driving tractors every day. Although I love driving tractors, using different equipment is always fun. Does it actually zero turn like real life? It does, look at that. That must have taken ages to design in Farming Simulator. I really hope they have something like this in FS17 because it's really handy. I don't really know why they got rid of it for 15. Although, having said that, you can download it again as a mod. Almost done, and what a difference it makes giving it a quick cut. Usually it's just like a jungle, it gets so long. But just giving it a quick mow makes it look so much better. Actually, I will check. Let's see if we have any fields ready to harvest for tomorrow, because I'd love to do some. This is where pink. Pink for sunflowers. Yes, which fields do we own? Field number 15, 4, 13 and 11, the 4 we've just done. I don't think we own anything else which is ready to harvest. No, we don't. So, what I think we should do, if we can afford it, is buy some fields over here, or buy a field over here, and do a big harvest, because with the soil mod, even the fields you don't own wither, which is a big problem. So we really do need to get some done. We need to buy some and get them harvested. Ideally, the canola. Because, obviously, it's worth the most. And if you can make back the money it cost you to buy the field in the first place, you're doing pretty well. Anyway, yeah, basically, what I'm trying to do is find some different stuff to do in the videos in the moment, because we're just kind of waiting now for FS17. And we've done most of the jobs before, so I'm finding it hard to keep the videos fresh, to be honest. I wouldn't usually say that, but I am. And especially as some people have started to complain. I know it's only a minority, I know, but some people do. So if I can do some stuff like this to keep it different, I think it should go down pretty well. Anyway, we're done. What a difference it makes too. Let's get it back onto the trailer. I'll try and go up in fours this time, see if it works. Pretty steep area, I probably shouldn't have put the trailer right back up here. But, there it is. It's on. Handbrake on. And yes, let's put the ramp up at the back. Lock the implements or the machines onto there. And let's go over to field number 40. Is it 17? I don't know. I forget. Yeah, 17. But yeah, decent mod. Very decent. And it comes with everything. It's not just the mowers it comes with. I probably should have shown you this actually. I'm not sure the category. I don't know what category they're in. But I do know that there is other stuff. I just need to find it. I didn't really download it for this. But I know there is like a water bowser kind of thing. I'm not sure what it is exactly. Oh, there we go. Lawn sprayer. The X-Mark lawn sprayer. So that provides NPK for the fields. So we could do that in the orchard because everything with Saw Mod requires fertilizer. But yep, I think tomorrow we'll be doing some harvesting. Most likely something like field 27, 28 maybe. Whatever we can afford without going too close to zero in the bank balance, because that is so easy to do. We need to get some more money in, desperately. And here we go. So the orchard area isn't actually that big here, so this won't take very long. We're in. And I think these trees are ready as well. They're all ready to harvest. We'll unlock them from the trailer. Turn the tractor's engine off. And begin once again. Slow and steady. Okay. Let's start. It really is just the orchard area I want to do. Keep it nice and neat. I wonder if there's any like tractor mowers for Farming Simulator. I know there used to be like a Murray. I think it was a Murray Ride-On for FS11. Long time ago now, but I don't know. There might be. I'd love to use one. Yeah, really in my element doing this. I love mowing the grass. I don't know why. I always have done. Just look at me. Yes, really happy. Looking a bit stunned, but still. Oh. Yep, still enjoying it. I love doing this. I get a bit carried away. Zero turn. Amazing. Love the mod. So yeah, download it below. Definitely worth it. Right. We are almost there. I'm finishing up going around in circles. Going around each tree. Need to make it look nice and neat. It doesn't need to be over the top though. And it's obviously easier with the bagger to smash off that side chute on the trees. So we've got to be extra careful. But I think really that is it pretty much done. It's been great fun. So we'll have to take it back over to the trailer. And we'll head back to the yard. Need to find a secure storage point for it. Yeah, that would do. So, yeah, switch it off. Head over here. There we go. Good, so yeah, brilliant fun. Love using them. I'll have to try and find some more mods very similar to this because they are great fun to use and I think they do bring a bit more to a video as well. Diversifying the jobs. The quad bike looks to have moved forward. I'm not sure what that is, but it should be okay. I think probably if we put it in a shed around the back of the farmyard, it should be the best place for them. It just depends how secure it is, I suppose. And I'm pretty sure they should be able to stay on the trailer. Yeah, the oat field, which is on our right hand side, along with field number four actually. Hoping they won't be too long. Obviously they're on a very early growth stage still, but the sooner they're done the better, because I can't wait to do another oat harvest. Right, yes, in here. I think really, just in this open fronted barn over here should be okay. Or maybe that one there. But next time we'll definitely have to put it on a pickup truck or something, because it's obviously not the right tractor for the trailer, because those back wheels are just off the ground and all the weight's on the front too. But that is it for today. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video, something a little bit different to usual. And until the next video, thanks again, and I'll see you again soon. Bye for now.